गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल रेज अकेड एंड टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ कोलिजन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट अ न्यू टॉपिक कोलिजन। ओके, सो व्हाट इज कोलिजन? Two body when they are moving with same velocity, then they are said to be collide with each other. Okay, so in this we can take an example. So when two body move with same velocity, can be termed as collision. For example, this is one block of mass m and this is another block of mass m. Okay, so what is the absolute meaning of this, that when two body are said to collide, that when they are moving with same velocity, when two body move with same velocity, when two body are said to be collide with each other, when they move with same velocity. Okay, so like it is send mass m1 is sent with velocity v1 and mass m2 is sent with velocity v2. So when they both will collide, then their velocity of both will be v. And the spring has maximum deformation, means it is maximum compressed, means the potential energy of the spring is maximum. So what is collision? When two bodies will said to be collide, when they will move with same velocity. Here we have example, like it has a mass m1 and it has a mass m2, and they are said with velocity v1 and v2. So when they will both moving with same velocity, at that particular moment we will say that they are the two mass are collided with each other. Okay, so moving on to the next concept in collision, okay, so moving on to next concept, basic steps of collision. In this we will be discussing concepts of elastic collision, and inelastic collision. So in the elastic collision, what is there? That if two bodies or balls will collide with each other, then after some time they will gain its original shape and potential energy will not be lost. Okay, and but in the inelastic collision, the balls will stick to each other and the potential energy of some part of that will be lost in the form of heat or sound. Okay, so describing the elastic collision, elastic collision. Okay, in this potential energy is conserved. सो लाइक इन द इलास्टिक कोलिजन प्रॉब्लम्स वी कैन कंजर्व एनर्जी, ओके, पोटेंशियल एनर्जी एंड काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज ऑल्सो कंजर्व इन दिस, पोटेंशियल एंड काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज ऑल्सो कंजर्व इन द इलास्टिक कोलिजन. ओके, सो लाइक दिस इज अ बॉल वन एंड दिस इज अ बॉल टू, दिस इज मूविंग विद वेलोसिटी वी वन एंड दिस इज मूविंग विद वेलोसिटी वी टू. सो इफ वी वन इज ग्रेटर देन वी टू देन ओनली द बॉल्स विल collide with each other. Suppose that it is of mass m1 and it is of mass m2. If it is clearly seen that if v1 is greater than v2, then only the balls will collide, and after some time, like it has a velocity v3 and it has a velocity like it has a velocity v4. So like in this we can conserve the kinetic energy and potential energy, like half mv1 square plus half mv2 square is equals to half mv3 square plus half mv4 square, potential energy is also conserved in this, and coefficient of restitution, which is E, is 1 here. Okay, this what is this we will discussing later in this chapter. Okay, so now moving on to inelastic collision. Inelastic inelastic collision, okay. In this, potential energy is not conserved. Kinetic energy is not conserved. They both are lost in the form of heat or sound. Lost in form of heat or sound. Okay, so in this we cannot conserve that kinetic energy, like half mv1 square plus half mv2 square. This we cannot do in this. This we have to remember that if inelastic collision is mentioned in the problem, then we can't conserve the energy in this. Energy is not conserved. Okay, and after this, that the ball will stick to each other and move with a same velocity v3. They will not move like this, separate balls. They will stick to each other and combine as a one object and will proceed further, and some part of it is of energy will be lost. Okay, so moving on to the next concept in collision. Moving on to the next concept, deformation at the time of collision. Deformation at the time of collision. So, when the two bodies collide, they are not perfectly circular. They are somehow like this. Okay, and moving like with velocity v. So they are not perfectly circular. So the potential energy stored within the system is like firstly they are moving with velocity v1, second one is moving with velocity v2, and both have mass m. So and like m1 m2, okay, so what will be the potential energy stored? Half m v1 square plus half m v2 square minus half m v1 plus v2 whole square is equals to potential energy stored in the system at the time of collision. Okay, so this will be the potential energy stored at the time of collision. Okay, so in this we can also do momentum balance and kinetic energy balance. So momentum balance mv1 plus mv2 is equals to m1 v1 plus m2 v2 is equals to m1 plus m2 into v. Okay, this is the momentum balance. Momentum balance equation. Okay. Okay. So then moving on to kinetic energy balance. So what we will do in this, half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square is equals to half m1 plus m2 into v square. This is the equation of kinetic energy balance. So if in any question it is need, then we can write this. Okay. Then moving on to coefficient of restitution. E is defined as relative speed of separation upon relative speed of approach. Relative speed of separation upon relative speed of approach. Okay, so this is E. Relative speed of separation upon relative speed of approach. So E is separation V4 minus V3 upon V2 minus V1. And E is equal to 1 if the collision is elastic. E is 1 if collision is elastic. Okay. This is the equation of E, V4 minus V3 upon V2 minus V1. And like this is V1, this is V2, and this is V3, and this is V4. All have mass m. So this is the equation of coefficient of restitution. Okay. So seeing some graphs in collisions. Graphs in collisions. So if it is a elastic collision, then potential energy versus time and काइनेटिक एनर्जी वर्सेस टाइम, इट इज लाइक दिस, दिस इज पोटेंशियल एनर्जी, काइनेटिक एनर्जी वर्सेस टाइम इट इज लाइक दिस,
ओके,
दिस इज यू. एंड इफ इट इज अ इन इलास्टिक कोलिजन देन ग्राफ इज लाइक दिस, दिस इज हीट, काइनेटिक एनर्जी वर्सेस टाइम ग्राफ. इन इलास्टिक कोलिजन काइनेटिक एनर्जी वर्सेस टाइम इज लाइक दिस. डाउन हाइपर डाउन पैराबोला, इट इज ऑल्सो अ डाउन पैराबोला, इट इज ए अप पैराबोला. इन इलास्टिक कोलिजन ऑफ काइनेटिक एनर्जी ग्राफ, सो इट इज ए डाउन पैराबोला इन इनइलास्टिक कोलिजन ऑफ काइनेटिक एनर्जी, एंड इट इज ए अप पैराबोला इन काइनेटिक एनर्जी इन इलास्टिक कोलिजन. ओके, सो दिस दीज ग्राफ्स वी हैव टू रिमेंबर, लाइक वन क्वेश्चन कैन कम ऑफ आइडेंटिफाइंग द ग्राफ्स, देन वी कैन ईजिली आइडेंटिफाई विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस कॉन्सेप्ट. ओके, concept we will be discussing in the collision chapter is impact force. Impact force. So at force the impulse given by the impact force is very large, so we cannot neglect at this force at the time of collision. This is the impulse concept. The impulse given by impact force is very large at the time of collision, so we can't neglect. Okay, so one bullet of mass is small m, and this is a block of mass capital M, and this is forcefully ejected in this, like it has a velocity of v, and like v1 here and v2 here, so mu n force, frictional force will act in opposite direction, and they both will be moving with m and small n and capital M with velocity, let's suppose v. So in this, how we will do the momentum balance is minus mu n delta t, minus mu n delta t is equal to m small m v1 plus small m plus capital M into v. So this is the we can call in the y direction, like n is acting normal reaction, so n delta t is equal to 0 minus of m V2. These both are in J direction. Okay, so this is the balance in the Y direction. So this is the concept of impact force. Okay.